Hey guys, welcome to a much needed Cantina diorama update. I hope you like that introduction. It really dawned on me that I never really talked about, besides doing tutorials and stuff, but talked about doing the actual bar spigots themselves. So what I'm going to do today is go through and I'm going to try to describe as best I can, okay? Hopefully within 15 minutes, because that's all I want to give Facebook. All right, guys. All right, let's do this. I only have a one of the best Cantina members for scale because I had put the figures away in the meantime because this whole COVID thing, and I'm just now getting back into wanting to get this completed. So thanks for hanging on, guys. I'm going to turn this down a little bit here. All right. So as you can see, there is a lower bar shelf area, or glass shelf, knickknacks, doodads, or what have you. All the glasses are permanently on there. In fact, everything here is permanent, except for a couple floating pieces in the center here. Okay. The pieces right here, the ones that look like the IG-88 heads, okay, I customized them big time. I received them from Izzy Mel as a gift from somebody else. So I thought that was pretty cool. Anyhow, so I sanded them, painted them, you know, it's best I know how. I'll give you scale, just put my finger up there. So the IG-88 was based off these components which were part of a Rolls-Royce engine part. Okay, the combustion area, I believe. So I modeled it to, I would say, 99.9% accuracy to movie accuracy behind the scenes and all those shots. I labored over this for about a year to complete it because I just would stare at photos and try to understand what's going on with the piping system, as you can see here. It's just a labyrinth going on. All the pipes are made out of dowel rods. You can find them at most craft stores and probably Walmart. I don't have specific sizes, but, you know, everything was just, you know, I made it up as I went along and tried different things. All right, so right here, sorry guys, I'm trying to make it such a production with playing music, it's becoming a hassle. All right, so carrying on, I'm glad you're still with me because it's after 6 minutes. So all right, right here, this is electrical cord, okay, and I just use that. I can't get into specifics on how I did it because it's just labor pain intensive. So we have the pieces coming down, the little stems coming down from the heads there. Okay, like I said, I customized the heads a little bit more and I gave them some decorations of things, you know, like if you look on here, you can see this. All right, you can see that little nodule coming out. I tried to mimic what was going on in the movie. Because remember, IG-88 was created from these, so of course they modified the hell out of these heads. That's why they look so different. Sorry, guys. So these two pieces, the IG-88 heads, and then these canisters here, were 3D printed, okay, to scale for 3.75. I handmade this because, you know, there was no file for it for anybody to print, and it's made out of a fishing bobber that I had sealed and then spray painted gold and strapped some masking tape around the edge here just to build it up to give it that pattern that's got going on in the movie. Okay, and then of course, you know, when you enter the Cantina, and mostly everybody remembers it from this angle, you know, coming front up, front on. So you can see I got the pipes going on up and down over here, and then I, you know, each head has its appropriate color according to the movie, and it's even positioned exactly in what direction it is in the movie too. I'm that OCD about it. Okay, let's continue on down over here. You can see here are the control panels. You don't really see them in the movie. There is one behind the scenes shot that you can see it. Okay, and of course, according to the blueprint, it says there are four of them, four or five. This is a modified bar here to extend out into the additional back bar area that goes under the alcove. And I'm going to show you that as soon as we close out this video, how it goes in. All right. Same thing. We got the silver parts. I mean, they, you know, there was so much lighting bouncing off each other, you know, off of different surfaces, because, you know, all the high chrome and, you know, the brass tones going on, that it seemed like it was always changing, or maybe my eyes were changing. But so yeah, the way I did, what I had to do is, like, for example, I started off with the centerpiece here, and I built that, and I built onto it, and what I had to do was put two dowel rods together, and then I wrapped it in a real thin piece of masking tape to give it that elbow joint look, and then I covered it in Mod Podge, and it dries to its surface, but it creates a real nice seal, and it keeps it really strong. Well, I had to apply like three or four layers on each corner, and then I would spray paint it. But before I spray painted it, I had to design and determine which, how the bends went, and I had to, you know, make some things in the future, some things in the past, but everything attached and connected together in certain areas is a combination of Mod Podge and super glue. And I used super glue gel. Okay, it works best because you could actually pick at it if you have some overbleeding with it. You can see this angle from Obi-Wan's shoulder, kind of, when he's standing by Chewbacca. You can see that piece right there is extending out. Looks like it's floating, you know, but it has a little peg on there. And there's some metal components that are behind there. And I, again, you know, a lot of this was imagined and based off of illustrations and what other fans have done. And from what I can see from the movie, now everybody says to use the blueprint, but the blueprint also changes. So there were a lot of changes going on. So I did my best to recreate that back area. And then we have the copper pipes. And like I said, it does light up in the middle right there, right over Luke's shoulder when he has Spoor for a drink. You can see that it's lit up. Okay, these are Lego pieces. They're free-floating right now. I'm thinking about just, you know, painting them and gluing them in place so they don't look so much like Legos. And of course, I'll cover the bottom part with, you know, some sort of thin plastic, just so that they look like boxes, you know. All right, let's go ahead and check out a different angle here, guys. I'm gonna flip it around, turn it around. I mean, I'm not gonna flip it, but, you know, hey, I could I could turn it, nothing's gonna fall off. Okay, but like I said, there's that free floating piece in the front, but just because I left it free floating, because I needed it to be a positional piece so I know exactly where everything needs to be placed, if that makes sense. All right, and here's the other side here. I'll let you gaze upon that for a moment. Like I said, all the centerpieces, all the canisters that are supposedly like holding the liquid or the alcohol concoctions and stuff, those I had to hand make. But like I said, these pieces here were 3D printed, and I added pieces like this elbow bend right here above it. These are straight pins, glued in somewhat to the best I could. I mean, I didn't want it look like it's coming through, but in some parts, the needle is coming through, and it's just masking tape wrapped around and then glued, mod podged and sealed and nice and solid. And I even put little rivets at the bottom and stuff, just like what they have in the movie. Okay. Yeah, I was really excited. I was able to come up with, how to duplicate, the stems coming from the components. And this is the other side here, and then this, reaches to the back. So I'm going to go ahead and show you around a little bit more here, and then I'm going to lead you out into the inside of the cantina. All right, guys. I'm glad you're still hanging on. If you are, thank you so much. I hope this helps you out in your own diorama projects, but we're going to go ahead and lead you out of me putting it inside the bar. As you can see, it's all over the place right now, Gav. All my projects. There's Obi-Wan's home. Right behind those two rockets, which are part of the Cantina. On the outside, y'all recognize those. Alright, so let's go back to the Cantina. This is what we're doing, okay. Alright. If you like that, guys, I'm pretty sure you're enthused. Sorry for all the shaking. Alright, guys. See what I was talking about with the bar extending into the back bar? This was all based off the illustration of the cross sections. I retained a really good friendship with the illustrator who did the actual Cantina, and he gave me his blessing. However, there are, respectfully, some things that are not right. Okay, sorry. Alright, so just, I'm getting back to work, so, you know, doing this video, and of course, you know, it's nearly 25 minutes, it's really because, you know, I've been missing it, so I'm just showing some love for it, and I hope you show some love back for it as well. I'm sorry for the shakiness towards the end and everything, but I don't have a tripod anymore, so I'm just doing my best to come up with whatever I can to hold the camera, So, all right. I will be doing a page dedicated to the Cantina, which will have a ton of random pictures. And I hope you receive the message or notification that I invited you to like the page, and I hope you do. Okay, so, but in the meantime, enjoy the video, you know, show your friends, please share. Lots more stuff coming on with the Cantina. I'm not going to get into details of what's going on, but you can see right now it's still sitting up here on the table the same way it is since March of this past year. So, you know, obviously the COVID and everything, and I needed to spend my money towards other things. Plus, too, you know, family issues come up and you have to deal with those. All right. But anyhow, thanks for coming by. Thanks for spending 25 minutes with me. I really appreciate it. But this video needed to be done. So many people have been asking. I can't even keep track, and I've been so busy and not responding to messages, and I do apologize, but it is what it is. Okay. All right, guys. Please enjoy. I love you. You be well. You be kind. And, you know, mask up, okay? You know, let's get through this shit. All right. All right, guys. May the force be with you.